You want to read this with me, Jacque?
No, this is all you, kid.
Well, the Droughtlander is almost over. And after a shocking season finale, fans of the hit show can't wait to see what's happening on Fraser's Ridge.
All right, this is going to continue.
If you watch, you understand.
All right, well, navigating relationships can be tough for Bree and Roger, played by Sophie Skelton and Richard Rankin, especially when their choices can alter history.
It would be safer in your time.
You want to go back, don't you? Our family is here.
You are my family.
I am to keep people safe here. I need to know what's causing their illnesses.
Isn't this playing God?
I swore an oath to the crown, but I will not stand by and watch my kin killed.
People consider this to be the spark of the American Revolution. If we stop this fight now, America will never become America.
Oh my goodness. And Richard and Sophie are with us now. Welcome back, guys.
Thank you.
So season four ended. We finally got to see your characters reunite after many obstacles. Tell us what we can expect for this season without giving too much away. No, tell us everything.
Yeah.
It's a full breakdown. Well, we pick up pretty much where we left off. There's a bit of a time lapse. Obviously now they're new parents. There may or may not be a wedding. And for Roger and Bree, their relationship's just in a much more secure, united place, which is lovely to see. But as with everything in Outlander, with the Frasers and Mackenzies, as soon as things are good, something else rocks the boat. So yeah, you're definitely in for a bumpy ride this season.
I feel like you want to add to that. I feel like you want to sing.
Yeah,
I think that's right. There's bliss, there's happiness, there's celebration. You see the family together. You see all of the characters that you love together, really for the first time.
So all good.
Cast together. Yeah, great.
Yeah. You know what? Nothing bad happens.
No
this
drama.
Season, all right? You don't need
season
to.
Season five is basically just a good time.
Wow. Good. Just smiles and laughs.
Exactly.
Okay.
Sounds
okay.
About right.
Yeah.
So, I was saying during the commercial break, this is a show you just keep hearing people say, do you watch Outlander? Do you watch Outlander? I've like fully invested.
That's me going around asking everyone.
Yes. Everybody needs to watch this show. It is that good.
Everybody pretty much does
watch it. Like, explain the premise for people in case they are new to it.
That's always really hard.
That's
it's when people are getting into the show and they say, do I need to start from the beginning? And I'm like, yeah,
I think it is a show that you do, which you can, because
okay, so
in
it's
a
based
nutshell.
On the international best-selling books written by Diana Gabaldon, and they've been out for kind of 26, 25 years. So you've got so many elements in there. A lot of it's rooted in real historical events, so like the American Revolution's brewing in this season, but you've also got a time travel element. It's an epic love story. There's lots of action. I don't know. It's just
sci-fi,
so much stuff.
Sci-fi, romance,
adventure. Yeah. It's kind of every genre in one. So.
Adventure.
Well, with
adventure.
Without giving too much away, tell us about being in Vogue and this wedding. What was that?
Oh my
experience
God.
Really like?
Cool. It was so much fun.
It's in my accent.
Yeah.
That was pretty incredible, wouldn't you say?
It was awesome, yeah. I was actually, when I saw it, I was trying to think how you would explain that to Brianna, this engineer from the 70s who goes back in time to the 1800s and then her wedding's in Vogue.
Yeah.
Just trying to work out what she'd think of that.
So did they come on you all set to do that? Like, how did this happen?
We were filming, and yeah, they came to visit us in Glasgow, and I think they were very lucky. I don't think it rained that day, did it?
No, we had extraordinarily lucky weather for that shoot. It was beautiful. The sun was out, which we don't see very often. Like 3 days a year we see that thing called the sun in the sky in Scotland, but
I do want to ask you guys about the super fans, because they are out in full force with this show, myself included. What's it been like interacting with them? Because I know you do on social media.
Yeah, it's always amazing. The fans are always so generous. Even today, you know, they always know where we are, don't they? And they come all over the world to visit, and you see a lot of the same faces. But we hear you have an admission to make to your husband.
Yeah, okay, well, my mother-in-law does watch the show. Do not tell Chris. So I told Chris I had to go back to the office. I needed to work, and I was really in my lobby binging this, so, yeah.
I love that. All right. Well, you can catch the season premiere of Outlander this Sunday at 8 p.m. on Starz. Great to have you both here.
Thank you so much.
Guys.